सर।
మై సుప్రీం నమస్కారం టు ఆనరబుల్ పద్మనాభరావు గారు అండ్ ఆనరబుల్ శైలజ మేడం గారు. వి ఆర్ అవేర్ దట్ వి హావ్ బీన్ టాకింగ్ ఇన్ ద ప్రీవియస్ లెక్చర్ అబౌట్ ద రైట్ టు ప్రైవసీ అండ్ how to control the right of us, all of us, in case of shutdown of internet, and what are the IT rules framed to regulate unlawful content. These were the things which we were discussing. And as an introduction, I like to repeat what he said the other day, just in few words, that the Constitution of India gives three important rights, out of which the right to protection of freedom of speech is very important, which says that Article 19 says that all citizens shall have the right to freedom of speech and expression. Of course, as we discussed the other day, this clause 19A has got 19(2), which says that in the interest of sovereignty and integrity of India, the security of the state, friendly relations with foreign states, public order, decency or morality, or in relation to contempt of court, defamation or incitement to an offense, reasonable restrictions can be imposed. Then we have another right, that Article 19G, which says to practice any profession or to carry on any occupation, trade or business. Even this right under Article 19G is covered by an exception or another section, another article, 19(6), which says that reasonable restrictions can be imposed in the interest of general public, reasonable or prevent the state from making any law. So far as existing laws are concerned, as insofar as it imposes that are there, they can be continued. So certain restrictions can be imposed by the state. State means central and the state governments, in case of necessity, in order to have clear and proper exercise of right to freedom of speech by all. In this regard, we were discussing about IT rules framed to regulate unlawful content. The other day I said to you that the government is contending that these rules were framed after holding public consultations with the stakeholders, and also the significant expansion of the online intermediary ecosystem, growth of online social media platforms and their influencing capabilities, and these are some of the reasons for framing the new rules. And it also claimed, the government also claimed, that the rules had been brought in to provide an institutional framework for digital media and OTT platforms. So the government is claiming that these rules are enacted bona fide for the benefit of the public, and they come under the Article 19, Clause 2 and Clause 6, which empowers the government to make laws which make reasonable restrictions. So we also aware that these rules are guidelines which includes Digital Media Ethic Code rules of 2021 are made to regulate publishers of news and current affairs on digital media and publishers of online curated content on over the top platforms from publishing unlawful content. This is what we discussed and understood the other day about new IT rules. We also further discussed that similar laws are made in other countries in order to control social media. Even the Supreme Court has held that Section 16A is unconstitutional. But even after that, some cases are filed infringing the judgment of the Honorable Supreme Court under alleging that the accused has committed offenses under Section 66A. We also discussed that in Germany, there is law which has come into force in 2018, which is called as NetzDG, which control YouTube and streaming services information, and all complaints are resolved within 24 hours. In case of need, fine is also imposed on the individuals if they commit violation of fundamental right to freedom of speech to an extent of 40 crores. And if it is institution, then 360 crores. In EU countries, that is European countries, general information security law is in force. In Australia also, about 2 years back, a law is made. We are aware that in our India, about 60 crores of people are one way or other way addicted to social media. But there are no clear and proper regular and reasonable laws are there to protect the right to freedom of speech and expression. So in this regard, the present rules have come into force, as per which the objectionable content or the false content has to be removed within 36 hours after receipt of the complaint. A system is also made to conduct an inquiry by the government after receipt of complaint, and that officer must be from India only. These laws are applicable not only the content that is generated in India, but also the content which are imported to India from other countries. So several cases are filed and they are pending in the Honorable High Courts and Supreme Courts. So with this background, let us see what is the protection bill that has come into force. Likely that will come into force likely in near future. nearly 21 months after the Personal Data Protection Bill was referred to a joint parliamentary committee, the report is not yet given because the new chairman, who is Mr. P.P. Chaudhary, who is an member of parliament of belonging to BJP, has observed that the work on the report will have to start afresh. You are aware that in the year 2019 only in the Lok Sabha, the Personal Data Protection Bill was introduced and soon after referred to the Joint Parliamentary Committee, which was then headed by BJP leader Meenakshi Lekhi. And 5 times extension is given for submitting the report. Mr. Lekhi has prepared a draft report, but he did not circulate it to others. Previously, there was 90 minutes debate in the parliament about this. The call for the data protection bill in the country has been growing stronger amid growing threat of data breaches due to sharp increase in cyber crime. As there is increase in the cyber crime, we are all asking that data protection bill must be there. It must control and do justice. You know, in the month of May of this year, 2 major firms, one is Air India and Jubilant Foodworks, witnessed security incident that put consumer data at risk. Suppose you traveled in Air India, your information is stored in the digital platform of Air India, and that is stolen. With that information, some offenses possibly can be committed by the intruders. So people are now asking how data can be protected. There must be data protection bill or law. What is cyber privacy? This bill, which is going to become a law after discussion or so what, it deals with broad guidelines on the collection, storage, and processing of personal data, the consent of individuals, penalties and compensation, and a code of conduct. It also deals with sensitive personal data, includes passwords, financial data, biometric data, health data, and other material specified by the government. Unless explicit or open consent of the person to whom that social data, whether sensitive personal data, is there, the said data shall not be allowed to be used by anybody. And further, this consent needs to be informed, clear and specific. So we need to have a data protection authority to prevent misuse of data. This is what people are now claiming or demanding or asking that in nutshell, they want to have cyber privacy. How to protect the privacy? Can we say that in India there is privacy or not? Definitely, we can say that the law says that, whether the Supreme Court held that right to privacy is a fundamental right. We will see about it in a famous case, what the Honorable Supreme Court has held about data privacy and whether it is a fundamental right or not. We have to closely see what the Supreme Court has held in respect of this data privacy, and also whether we are having a fundamental right to protect our data carefully or not. For this, we have to understand the case of Anuradha Bhasin versus Union of India. In this case, the Honorable Supreme Court, I am again repeating, please kindly note down, Anuradha Bhasin versus Union of India. This is a famous case. The top court ruled that any restriction on internet access, right to privacy and internet access, now have become fundamentally required for every citizen. So in this case, the Honorable Supreme Court held on January 10, 2020, that the access to information through the internet is a fundamental right under the Indian Constitution. So you are having a fundamental right to have access to internet. Internet is provided by the private companies. Whether there can be restrictions on the usage of internet or not is the main question. The Honorable Supreme Court held that not only that internet is a fundamental right under the Indian Constitution, but also any restriction on internet access by the government must be temporary, limited in scope, lawful, necessary, and proportionate. So you can't have an internet prohibition forever. If the government wants to impose some restrictions on the usage of internet, it must be temporary, limited in scope, lawful, necessary, and proportionate. While the Honorable Supreme Court in that case, Anuradha Bhasin versus Union of India, not only observed that internet is a fundamental right under the Indian Constitution, but also further held that if the government wants to put any restriction on internet access, the same should be temporary, limited in scope, lawful, necessary, and proportionate. And also further held that any order that may be passed by the government, even after making the said orders temporary, limited in scope, lawful, necessary, and proportionate by its order, the same is subject to review by courts. the courts can have. The same is subject to review by courts. So, if your right to internet is restricted, even temporarily, by claiming the same is necessary in the interest of public, and even it is limited in scope, lawful and necessary and proportionate, the same you can question in court of law and claim that a review is needed by the courts in order to see whether the said orders is necessary or not. The Honorable Supreme Court also held the instances of internet suspension to only those exceptional situations where there is a public emergency or threat to public safety. The legislatively mandated prerequisites for restricting internet access. If your internet access is restricted by the government by its orders, the government has to prove that the same is necessary in the interest of public, and it is required in view of public emergency or threat to public safety. These are the mandated prerequisites for restricting the internet access. But the government is not considering all these things. We have seen more instances of internet shutdown in India, which accounted for more than 70% of the total loss to the global economy in the year 2020 due to making restrictions on the usage of internet in India. In the year 2020, 70% of the total loss to the global economy has occurred. Not only this, India remains infamous as the internet shutdown capital of the world. In Jammu and Kashmir, recently there was restriction for access to mobile data in the valley of Kashmir when there was death of Gilani. All internet services recently also had shut down when Syed Ali Shah Gilani was dead. Even government of Haryana in 5 districts imposed internet restriction orders when there was farmers protested, and they conducted by organizing protests. But these orders, which shall be published in Gazette, are not being published. But the rule that is imposed by Honorable Supreme Court in Anuradha Bhushan versus Union of India is that if you want to put any restrictions, you must necessarily keep that on government websites. But that is not being done. In government websites, you have to upload about restrictions on usage of internet by imposing any order by the government for several reasons. The public will be able to understand that such restrictions are there in a particular area. Secondly, Right to Information Act also says that all the GOs or any important orders shall be kept in websites so as to prevent the people to approach the concerned authorities to issue certified copies or copies of the orders in that respect. But the governments are not uploading the orders that are passed on social media restricting the internet usage. So in the recently in May 2021 also, the government of J&K suspended internet services on three occasions in these districts. But the orders are uploaded after 1 month delay in the websites. So compliance with Anuradha Bhashin decision or guidelines is low, not only in Jammu and Kashmir, but also in other parts of India as well. Due to this, what is happening? People are losing trust. In 2020, the central government amended the telecom suspension rules 2017 to limit internet suspension orders to a maximum of 15 days. But unfortunately, this GO is also not uploaded in government websites. Further, nor did it include the Supreme Court's direction to undertake periodic review of these orders. When once you say that there is a necessity for restriction on internet usage and made an order, not only you shall upload it into website of government, but also periodic review of these orders shall be done. Apart from the fact that citizens have right to approach the courts to have judicial review of these orders. Interesting facts I am disclosing to you, which you feel as surprise, that many people are not aware about these guidelines that are given by Honorable Supreme Court in Anuradha Bhashin versus Union of India. This lack of awareness about these rules and the mandatory obligations that have to be followed by the government clearly shows that the state and central governments are not interested to comply with the guidelines of Honorable Supreme Court of India. Unless we read and study the decision of the Honorable Supreme Court as opposed to simply looking at the rules to understand the obligations on the government, we will not be able to follow the same, which means that there is a violation of right to freedom of speech and expression and right to freedom to have any profession of your choice. I am going to give one more example about how there is a lack of awareness of this law. In respect of Section 66A of the Information Technology Act, we have experienced that the Supreme Court decisions are not statutorily recognized. The officials enforce the law incorrectly. It is all being done simply because of a lack of awareness. The state government of Meghalaya, in a reply to an RTA application, stated that it was not even aware of the judgment of Honorable Supreme Court in Anuradha Bhashan, even though 8 months had passed since the Supreme Court's pronouncement. So because of lack of knowledge, not only there are violations of the laws and also infringement of fundamental rights of citizens, but also there is wide-ranging impact due to suspension of internet usage. When we consider all this, we can surely say that the harm that is done to the society due to shutdown of internet is very high. There is economic, psychological, social and juristical, journalistic harm caused by such suspensions, and it outweighs any speculative benefits, because we don't know what is the impact, whether really there will be any loss to public and such rules are required or not. Internet suspension ought to be imposed in times of emergency and not to stifle the democratic exercise of the right to protest. In those times, the internet is a necessity to seek help. Moreover, it is also a tool to verify rumors and enables individuals and the government to disseminate the truth. The government will do well to recognize that offline rumors can also misguide the public. So, if the internet is there, then people can verify whether any rumors that are passed in media or otherwise are true and correct. So, internet restrictions are often justified on the ground that they are limited to mobile data services. These contentions also miss the point. In 2019, Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, that is TROI, report on Indian telecom services performance indicators, mobile device users, dongle and phone constituted 97.02% of total internet users. Only 3% of users have access to broadband net internet. So broadband internet continues to be expensive. So internet restrictions also tend to adversely affect those from lower socio-economic backgrounds more. It's not only detrimental to the rich people, but also the people who are lower socio-economic background also really affected. So as Honorable Supreme Court has held, and also it has permitted the government to restrict internet access only in limited circumstances. The Parliament has also allowed these restrictions only in a public emergency or when